In this video, you'll see how to create a chart control in a WinForms application, bind it to a data source, customize the chart's main elements, and change its appearance and interaction settings. Let's start with a new WinForms application created with the DevExpress template gallery. To add a chart control, locate the chart control item in the DX13.1 Data and Analytics Toolbox tab and drop it onto the form. Click the Chart Control Smart tag to invoke the chart control tasks. In the tasks list, click the Dock and Parent Container link. This allows the chart control to occupy all of the available space on the form. Now let's add a data source. To do this, in the invoked chart control tasks, open the drop-down list for the Choose Data Source Type and click the Add Project Data Source link. The Data Source Configuration Wizard will appear. Select the database icon and click Next. In the Choose a Database Model page, click Next. On the Choose Your Data Connection page, click the New Connection button. Specify local for the server name. Next, click the Select or Enter a Database Name combo box and select InWind. Click OK to close the Add Connection window and then Next to switch to the next wizard page. Configure the Choose Your Database Objects page, expand the Products table from the database, choose Product Name, Category ID, Units in Stock, and Units on Order fields. To complete the data source creation, click Finish. Now the Products Binding Source object is assigned to the chart control. Next, let's run the chart wizard. To do this, use the Chart Control Smart tag by clicking the Run Wizard link. Let's change the default series names. Switch to the Series Wizard page and specify the first series name as Units in Stock and the second series name as Units on Order. Next, switch to the Data page and select the Series Binding tab. For the first series, set the argument combo box to product name and the value combo box to units in stock. For the second series, set the argument combo box to product name and the value combo box to units on order. To limit the number of data points in each series, choose the first series and click the Data Filters Ellipsis button in the Data Wizard page. In the invoked Data Filter Collection Editor, click Add and then set datafilter.columnName to category ID and datafilter.value to 4. Leave the datafilter.condition property set to its default value, equal, and click the Close button. Then repeat these actions for the second series. And click Finish to close the wizard. To see how the resulting chart will finally look at design time, click the Populate link in the Chart Control Tasks list. This will redraw the chart using the obtained data. Okay, now let's run the application to see the results. Next, let's change the series view type. To do this, click the Run Wizard link in the Chart Control Smart tag at design time. Switch to the Series page and change the Series View type to Area for the Units in Stock series. Next, we'll customize the legend position on a diagram. Let's switch to the Legend page, set the Direction combo box to left to right. In the Alignment group, set Vertical Alignment to Bottom Outside and Horizontal Alignment to Center. Next, click Finish to close the wizard. You can customize the chart appearance and behavior changing the corresponding properties in the Properties grid. Switch to the Properties tab. As you can see, the main chart properties can be grouped into three categories. Appearance. This category is used to determine the overall look and feel of a chart. Let's change the chart's default appearance. To do this, set the Appearance Name property to Pastel Kit. Behavior. Contains properties that allow you to control the chart's interaction tools, tooltips, and crosshair cursor, and change the common chart behavior. In this section, we're going to change the crosshair cursor behavior. Let's show the crosshair value line. To do this, locate crosshair options and set the Show Value Line property to true. And finally, elements. You can add or delete chart elements, for example, diagram, series, annotation, and legend, and modify their properties. You can see the crosshair cursor with value lines that provides a convenient way to compare series. Finally, we'll demonstrate how to change a view type for multiple series. Let's run the wizard. In the chart type page, select radar and polar series from the drop-down list. Next, click radar line, and the chart type has been changed automatically. Let's switch to the chart titles page. To create a title for your chart, click the Add button on the right pane. Specify the products text in the text tab, and you can see this title on the left pane of this wizard page. Close the chart wizard by clicking the Finish button. And finally, let's run the application to see the result. As you can see, tooltips appear each time the mouse cursor hovers over a series point. Note that the radar series doesn't support a crosshair cursor, so tooltips are showing automatically instead. And that's it. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.